But here's some good news. We have hit another huge vaccination milestone. Over 90% of Australians over the age of 16 have now had at least one vaccination.
Yeah, it's great, isn't it? President of the AMA, Dr. Omar Korsha, joins us with the latest. Thank you for coming on the show. So this is an incredible world-leading achievement, I would suggest. We may have started out slowly, but we're sure bringing it home with a hiss and a roar, aren't we?
Isn't it great to see these numbers so high, Richard? We are now at around 70% of our entire population. That's every man, woman and child in the country. And that puts us certainly in the top 10% in the world. And we are streaking up that leaderboard from where we started. And I think if you look back at the start of the program and could have offered us this outcome at this time, I think pretty much anyone would have taken it.
We are still seeing pretty high case numbers in Victoria, though. They've been above 1,000 despite the high vaccination rates. Do you think they're going to drop soon like they have in New South Wales?
I think they're going to drop quite slowly, and we have seen that happening now since opening up. The reality was that Melbourne opened with, what I think it was 25,000 active cases that we knew about in the community. So a very different situation to Sydney, and that's why it's taking so much longer for those cases to come right down. But there is light at the end of the tunnel. We're actually seeing some elective surgery starting now in Victoria, which hasn't been the case for a long time. And that's a sign that the government's more confident now about the state of their hospital system and that these numbers are going to continue to drop and not spike in coming weeks.
Yeah, meantime, in your neck of the woods, reports say that WA is planning to ban quarantine rules for visiting cricket players, the Australian and the English teams, to make the Ashes test in Perth. A lot of people are calling this out for being a double standard. Do you reckon it's fair when, you know, we have to quarantine if we go in there?
Even if
Victorians can't,
yeah.
You know. It's a double standard, surely.
Look, if there's one thing Aussies don't like, it is those double standards. Mm. And there's no doubt a lot of people have good reasons for coming to WA, compassionate reasons,
exactly.
And they're finding it extremely difficult at the moment. So we would like to see a more flexible approach from the government to very low-risk travellers. But I think there's also a challenge here for all of us. If we want to be travelling at the same time as these cricketers, let's get vaccinated. Let's hit our targets before then, and we can all be up and about around the country by the time that test match happens.
Yeah.
In other news, though, Doctor, Pfizer's antiviral pill could be available for use early next year. What do we know so far about this drug?
So this is one of two oral, so tablet, antiviral medications that are really exciting. At the moment, the results haven't been checked by others, but from what the companies are saying, one of them is around 50%, and this Pfizer drug, which is actually two different drugs in the one pill, claiming to have a 90% effectiveness against hospitalisation and death. So that's great news for those breakthrough cases where people haven't had the protection from the vaccine, and we can still hopefully treat them and keep them out of hospital.
These drugs are promising to change the way that we live with the virus, but is there a risk that this drug, you know, could encourage the unvaccinated to double down and not get the jab, or does the end justify the means?
Well, at the end of the day, we want to treat people who get sick, and the best thing you can do is, of course, not get sick in the first place. And that's why vaccines are by far the best way to protect yourself against COVID. It's far cheaper for the community, and you haven't got the side effects of potent medications that we haven't heard much about yet with these drugs. But at the end of the day, if you do get sick, wouldn't you like to have a highly effective treatment option that you could go to your GP and get, rather than having to present to a hospital and get an intravenous infusion, which is the case right now if you get COVID?
And if we knew 18 months ago that we'd be in this situation right now, I think we'd all be pretty pleased with that.
Yeah, very true. Isn't it, just finally, so it's incumbent on us now, surely, to make sure our neighbours are as vaccinated as we are, isn't it?
Well, we've got to finish the job of vaccinating the whole world. And if you look at that league table of countries, yes, Australia's doing pretty well, but there's an awful lot of countries down the bottom with almost no vaccination availability for their people. It's not just our near neighbours, it's the whole planet. Mm. Because while there's millions of cases around, the virus will be mutating and it could come back despite our drugs, despite our vaccination program. We could still face very significant problems in the future. So we do need to finish that job, absolutely, Richard.
Thank you very much, sir.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Omar Korsha, for your time. Thank you.